Hello everyone, my name is Dark Hero, welcome back to my channel where we cover Monster Hunter content. I'm so glad you are here, and today I'm going to be telling you guys how you can solo Arc-Tempered Nergigante very easily. Yes, I know, Arc-Tempered Nergigante can be very difficult at first. His new moves are very powerful, he deals a lot of damage, and he is insanely fast. But despite all of this, I have created a build that makes it very easy to defeat Arc-Tempered Nergigante. I mean, you guys are seeing it in action here in the video, and as you can see, I can easily block each attack that Arc-Tempered Nergigante throws at me, and it doesn't even deal all that much damage. What's more is that I have only realized after killing Arc-Tempered Nergigante for the third time that I was using pieces without even upgrading them. Yes, I mean I didn't spend a single armor sphere in any of the pieces that I'm using. I totally forgot to go to the blacksmith and upgrade each of the armor pieces, and still this build was working very well as you can see from the gameplay in the background. So what build am I using in this video? The key component of this build is the gunlance that I'm using, not specifically this one, but a gunlance with a white shelling of level 4. That is what you want to be looking for because of the playstyle that we will be using throughout the video. The gunlance that I'm using specifically in this video is the Terroth Buster Water, which comes with 437 base attack and has a hidden element of 450 water element. What's more, this weapon also comes with a decoration slot, which we will be using as you'll see later on in the video. The idea behind using this weapon is that I wanted to have a shield and be able to block all of the attacks that Nergigante will be throwing at me. After all, he is much more powerful in the Arc-Tempered state. The problem that I would face with using the lance or the sword and shield, however, is that once Nergigante's spikes grow black, you will not be able to hit Nergigante because your weapon will be bouncing off unless you bring Mind's Eye with you, but even if you bring Mind's Eye with you, you will still be dealing a lot less damage. So I went with the gunlance because I am able to block every incoming attack, but I am also able to use the explosive damage from the gunlance, which will not be affected by the black spikes from Nergigante. And as you can see from the gameplay in the background, all that I'm doing is using the gunlance to fire off some explosive ammunition and then quickly reloading before Nergigante hits me, and then I block before the attacks come and then turn back to using the explosive damage. So basically the combo is shoot once, shoot twice, quickly reload and then block, or maybe I'll block first and then reload slowly because sometimes Nergigante doesn't give you enough time to do a quick reload after you have shot the explosive damage. But sometimes Nergigante will grow tired and that gives you the opportunity to use the Wyvern's Fire to deal a lot of damage. You could go with a Charge Blade in theory because Charge Blade does come with explosive damage and it also has access to a shield, but I find it much easier to go with the Gunlance because with the Charge Blade you might not be able to get off a super amped elemental discharge before Nergigante hits you in the face. I mean, when I was doing Arc-Tempered Nergigante in multiplayer, one of our party members was using a Charge Blade and sometimes Nergigante would do the super dive bomb while he was doing the super amped elemental discharge, and while you can cancel out of the animation, it still takes a very long time to do the windup and you can still get hit by the Nergigante's attack. So again, I'm using the gunlance because of all the things I explained earlier and because you don't rely on attacks that have a long commitment time to do the damage. Now let's look at the armor pieces that I chose for this video. I am using the Empress Crown Beta, which comes with Evade Extender level 2, one level 3 decoration slot and one level 2 decoration slot. For the chest piece, I am using the Basal Mail Beta, which comes with Guard level 2 and two level 1 decoration slots. The Azure Starlord Gauntlets Alpha, which comes with Recovery Up level 2 and one level 3 decoration slot. The Valhazak Coil Gamma, which comes with Recovery Speed level 2, Dragon Attack level 1, one level 2 decoration slot and two level 1 decoration slots. The Empress Greaves Beta, which comes with Health Boost level 2 and two level 2 decoration slots. And finally the Artillery Charm 3 to get Artillery level 3. Then after slotting 2 Iron Wall Jewels, 2 Refresh Jewels, 1 Jumping Jewel, 1 Vitality Jewel, 1 Recovery Jewel and 1 Medicine Jewel, we end up with the following skills. Stamina Cap Up, which increases our overall stamina as part of the Lunastra set bonus. Guard level 4, which is going to reduce the knockback each time we block incoming attacks, and is also going to reduce the amount of stamina that is depleted each time we block. Evade Extender is going to increase the amount of distance that we travel whenever we use the evasion, and that is very useful with the Gunlance, because the Gunlance is not a mobile weapon at all, and you're going to need this because you do not want to sheath your weapon, because you want to always be prepared to block an incoming attack. Recovery up level 3 will increase the amount of health that is restored by 30%. The cool part about this is that this affects the items that you use to heal yourself, but also the health regen augmentation, which is what we are running on our Gunlance. So again, that means that you don't have to sheath your weapon to heal yourself, you just need to block the incoming attacks, and then as you deal damage you will be able to go back to full. Recovery speed level 3 quadruples the speed at which you heal recoverable damage, so again, this is all to make sure that you don't have to sheath your weapon to heal yourself. Any sort of red health that you may have in the health gauge will recover very quickly, so you don't have to worry about it at any point throughout the fight. Health boost level 3 is of course there to increase our health as much as possible. This is without a doubt the best thing that we have when it comes to defense, because this gives you the best bang for your buck when it comes to surviving incoming attacks. Artillery level 3 is here to increase our damage output, and this is why we're going with the artillery charm, because you may not have 3 artillery jewels, those are very hard to come by as they are very rare, and this is the only way that we have in this build of increasing our damage output, so you definitely want to have artillery level 3, otherwise you may not deal enough damage to take down your Gigante by the end of the fight. Tremor resistance level 3 is here because some of the attacks that Nergigante uses do cause some tremors, and you definitely don't want to be caught off guard by those, because if you are affected by a tremor you cannot block any incoming attacks, and Nergigante may take that opportunity to dive bomb you to hell and you will not be able to survive that. Stamina Surge level 2 is here because I didn't have enough jewels to get to guard level 5 and I still had 2 spare decoration slots, so I chose to go for Stamina Surge because that increases the rate at which your stamina recovers by 20%, and you may definitely see a benefit of having this, because if you're blocking a lot of attacks, you're definitely going to want your stamina to come back very quickly. And finally, Dragon Attack level 1 is just a byproduct of the build we're using, it doesn't affect us in any way, shape or form. And of course, when you're going for this fight, you definitely want to get the Feline Food skill, Feline Moxie, to be able to survive any attack that would normally kill you when you are at low health. Feline Insurance can also be very beneficial because it adds an extra card that you can have before you fail the quest, so that is always recommended when it comes to someone who is still having trouble with Archtemper Nergigante, as that will increase your odds of succeeding in defeating this monster. And of course you want to bring your Pelico for some extra assistance, and preferably he should bring the Vigor Wasp to be able to heal you throughout the fight, even though you may not need it because of the build we're using. It's always a good idea to come prepared to such a difficult encounter. Now for the Archtemper Nergigante moves, you definitely want to watch out for some of his quote-unquote combos. He is much faster now, and sometimes he will do a light jab and follow that up by a mini dive bomb, which is where he jumps very quickly, he goes up into the air, is only there for a second or so, and he immediately comes down with a super punch that deals a ton of damage. That definitely caught me off guard the first time I saw it, because I was only used to seeing the very slow and the original dive bomb. He still has that and it still deals a lot of damage, and if you're going to block that, be sure to take a bit more time and block even after the dive bomb has connected with you, because if he is enraged, the spikes will be flying off and it will cause a massive area of effect explosion that takes about a second or so after the impact has connected to actually deal the damage, so if you don't have the shield up, you're going to take a massive amount of damage, so you need to be careful about that. Also, Nergigante's tail swipe is surprisingly very powerful, so if you are playing in multiplayer and you have someone that is using a weapon like the longsword or a greatsword, maybe try to cut the tail as soon as possible, but if you're doing this solo, you definitely need to pay attention to where that tail is going, because sometimes it will reach you when you thought it was definitely not going to reach you. Other than that, take advantage of the turf war that Nergigante has with Kushala Daora and Teostra, depending on RNG, I guess. Whenever the turf war begins, take that opportunity to deal damage to Nergigante or to heal yourself. Also, near the first camp, in the very first area where Nergigante starts the quest, There are two pillars that of course you can bring down, and you can hit Nergigante with them for a lot of damage. If Nergigante flees that area before you bring down both of those pillars and he goes to the lava area, you can still kite him back to that area, so make sure that you provoke him and go back to the first area, and he should follow you there, and then you can stand below one of those pillars and make sure that it follows on top of him for again a great window of DPS. Also, one thing that may happen to you and may be very discouraging is that when you put on the Temporal Mantle, some of his attacks don't actually trigger the Temporal Mantle effect, so you don't roll through those attacks. And the attacks that Nergigante has that cause this, to my knowledge, are the light jabs that he has, so if you are in front of Nergigante when you have the Temporal Mantle on, please be careful with that, because you may actually die to those light jabs, because he is still pretty powerful and he still deals a lot of damage. And finally, of course, I could not end this video without mentioning the new tracks that play throughout the fight and the new soundtrack that also plays when you defeat Archtemper Nergigante. It's a bit of a mix between the regular Nergigante soundtrack but also the Monster Hunter World main theme, and I think that this is a very cool thing that the developers wanted to implement to give us as a treat for the game being released for over a year ago, and this of course being the flagship monster of the game. The Nergigante Gamma armor set that you get for defeating Archtemper Nergigante is actually very good. The legs especially are incredibly powerful. I will have a review of the armor set in a video, so do look forward to that. And for the layered armor set, we get the Ryu layered armor set, which is a shame because I don't think that anyone enjoys using it. It doesn't look good, it makes your character look like a character from another franchise, and you can't mix and match pieces with different armor pieces. So it's a bit of a shame. I was hoping that we would get a brand new layered set, but I guess that this is what the developers wanted us to have. But in any case, I am very happy with how Archtemper Nergigante turned out, and I think that he is my favorite out of the bunch. With that being said, let me know what you all thought of Archtemper Nergigante, which builds are you using to defeat him, and what strategies are you also using as well. Let me know all of that in the comment section down below. With that being said though, if you have enjoyed this video then please leave it a like, as it takes less than a second and it helps me out a lot. Subscribe if you're new to the channel and turn on channel notifications if you don't want to miss an ounce of Monster Hunter goodness. If you want to vote on what my next Monster Hunter top 10 or top 5 video will be, then head on over to Patreon and become a patron like these beautiful people. A big thank you to my patrons for choosing to support me and helping me keep this channel alive. You guys are my heroes, and a special thank you to Guild Arts Gaming for being a mighty hero. With that being said, thank you all so much for watching. My name is Dark Hero, and happy hunting!